Hi, Jacquie Herman's here, the Joyful Yogini. In this short practice, we are going to be opening up and igniting your sensuality and your sex drive. So that has to do with the second chakra, your sacral chakra. But also, we will have some focus on our root chakra because they work beautifully hand in hand. During this practice, you can think about the color orange, which is your sacral chakra, or the color red, which is your root chakra. And for this particular class, I also want you to think about the element of water. I want you to think about flowing. Okay, so I want you to meet me on the mat. We are going to meet in hero's pose. I am going to do hero's pose supported with a bolster between my legs. You can do that too if you want. You don't have to. You can also use a pillow if you don't have a bolster. So meet me on the mat and we'll get started. So we're starting in hero's pose. As you can see, oh, this is Chewy, and he normally joins in with my yoga classes. Sometimes he gets in the way because he's still a puppy, but he's a good guy. So as you can see, I have a bolster. I'm just going to get him situated. Okay, so to start this, I want you to take a deep breath in, reach up, breathe out, hands at your heart. Simply breathe in and out of your nose. If Ujjayi breath is part of your practice, you can activate that now. Basically, what it is as you are breathing out through your nose, you slightly constrict the back of your throat, and with your lips closed, it's as if you're trying to fog up a glass. And it sounds like the waves of the ocean. So keep breathing in and out through your nose. I want you to bring your attention to your genital area. And I want you to feel where it is in space or on your bolster, on your pillow, on your mat. Just bring your attention to it, and I want you to think about the color red, a beautiful red, swirling, circular energy that is opening and opening and being nourished. I also want you at the same time to bring attention to the bottom of your tailbone. And from both locations, you can picture roots coming out and down into Mother Earth. Connecting in, you can picture soil and rocks and crystals, and we're tapping into that beautiful Mother Earth energy, which is infusing all of our cells with wonderful, healing, beautiful energy. Now bring your attention to your sacral chakra, which is located just below your belly button, and it resonates at the color orange. So picture a circular, beautiful ball of energy spinning and opening and vibrating the color orange. This is your center of your sexuality, your fertility, your creativity. So feel that opening and opening. When you're ready, I want you to set an intention for this practice. Is there anything you want to let go of? Is there anything that you want to nourish during this practice? How do you want to feel by the end of this short practice? All right, once you have set your intention, I want you to slowly bring your hands down to the ground. If you have a bolster, you can move it out of the way. Okay, now I want us to go into a child's pose. So bring your knees to the outer edges of your mat, your toes to touch, and bring yourself down to your mat with your forehead touching the mat. If you have knobby knees like I do, you might even want to have a blanket or a second mat or your mat folded over just to give your knees a little bit of extra protection and comfort. So while you're here, I want you to bring your attention again to your genital area, to the base of your tailbone, and also to your sacral chakra, just located below your belly button. So feel where it is in space. Bring your attention to it. How does it feel right now? Are any thoughts coming into your mind's eye? Be an observer to your thoughts throughout this whole practice. Bring your attention to your hips and your thighs. Feel them opening with a gentle pulling. Okay, from here, I want you to reach your hands forward, bring your forehead a little bit forward, and we're going to go into puppy pose. So it means your hips are higher in the air. We're also getting a really nice stretch in our shoulders and upper back. Again, bring your attention to your first and your second chakra. Feel everything opening, activating. Your first chakra is where your passion is located. Your passion for life, your passion for people in your life, your passion for your career, for making a difference in the world. Okay, I want you to slowly come up to a tabletop position. So you're going to make sure that your hands are underneath your shoulders. So stack them underneath. And we're going to do a cat-cow. So first we're going to do our cow. So you're going to drop your belly, bring your heart up, bring your chin up slightly, breathe in. And then as you breathe out through your nose, round your back, belly button to spine, push that back up nice and high. Enjoy that stretch and breathe in back to cow. And breathe out to cat. And breathe in to cow. Breathe out to cat. Breathe in to cow. Last cat. Breathe in to flat back. Okay. From here, we're going to do some circles with our hips and going side to side with our hips. Let's start with going side to side. So just move them side to side and bring your chin close to your hips as you're going side to side. So you're creating a C with your body and a backward C. Enjoy that side body stretch. Okay. Now we're going to do some circles with our hips. So we're going to go one way and in and out. So with each side, push to each side. We're going to push to the left, push to the right. You can see as I'm going down, as I'm pushing back to one side and back to the other side. So I'm getting closer to my feet. And let's go the other way. If you've ever done belly dancing before, belly dancing is incredible for opening up your second chakra. So this move is bringing belly dancing to the mat. Let's go the other way. And again, the other way. Okay, excellent. Now, we're going to go into cobra, but flowing like water. Okay, so first we're going to come back towards our feet. And then we're going to bring our chin down, our arms forward, and slowly come up. And then let's go back. So it's more of an upward facing dog, I'd say, but we're keeping our knees down. And then around the back as you're going back. Chin close to the ground. And one more time this direction. And let's go back the other way. Feels a bit weird going back the other way at first. You just have to kind of find your way. You can't go down as low as you necessarily were. Okay, back to tabletop. Okay, from here I want you to lift that arm up and then thread the needle down. If it feels good on your shoulder, you can bring your arm to your back, or you can reach it out, have it beside your face. So what feels good for you? Bring your attention to your first and your second chakra, as well as your heart now. Now your heart is the color green. Your heart is the color green, or even pink for self-love. So you can think about those colors when you bring your attention to your heart. Okay, we're gonna unwind, reach up and down. Other side, up, let's come down. So again, you can have your hand by your face, reach it forward, or bring it back, which opens up your heart as well, and your shoulder. Again, you can think about the color green or pink for your heart, but also bring your attention to your first and your second chakra. I want you to feel what they're doing right now. Feel where they are in space. Okay, and up, unwind. Good. So from here, I want you to go into plank pose. Okay, now we're going to transition into serpent. So we're gonna take our right leg and bring it up to the outside of our right hand. So it's gonna be on the outside of the mat. You can bring that foot out as far as it feels comfortable for you. Now you can either keep your left leg up or you can bring the knee down, flatten the foot. Now you can stay here, you can even come up onto your fingertips and hold this pose. You can feel the stretch in your hip flexor on your left side, but also very much on the outside of your right hip. So staying here is fine, or you can take the stretch deeper. So I like to use props to go deeper. You might not need to. You can go right down and put your elbows on the mat if you like, or you can grab some blocks. Excuse me, Chewy. Okay, and then you can come down onto your forearms for a deeper stretch in your hips. And breathe. Bring attention to your first and your second chakra. Feel them right now in space. Whatever sensations you feel in your first and second chakra, just bring your attention to them. Bring your attention to the sensations in your hips. Be an observer of the thoughts coming in. With every breath in, think of lengthening and opening, creating space. And with every breath out, you can go a little deeper into the pose. But in a manner that feels good for your body today. If you feel like you need to stay exactly where you are, that is totally fine. Okay, one more breath in and out. Okay, let's transition back to plank. So you're gonna bring that leg back. Okay, so now we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Let's bring that left foot up. Okay, so again, this side, it might be different from the other side, so listen to your body. Position your foot where it feels good for you. You can stay here, you can go up onto your fingertips, or you can drop that leg down. Again, you can stay here, or you can come down onto the blocks. On this side, I can't get as deep. I find I'm tighter in my left hamstring. So just listen to your body and breathe. Observe your thoughts. Bring your attention to your first and second chakra. So as a reminder, your first chakra is located below your tailbone. It includes your genitals. Your legs are an extension of your root chakra. Your second chakra is between your hips. One more breath in and out. Okay, let's transition back to plank pose. Or you can simply come down onto your knees. I'm going to move the blocks out of the way. And let's do one little vinyasa, or you can go right to downward facing dog if you like, or child's pose. So I'm gonna breathe in, go forward on my toes, come down. Upward facing dog and downward facing dog. Okay, a couple breaths here. Bend your knees, look forward, and simply hop forward to get into a seated position. And come on down. Okay, we're going to go into cobbler's pose, but it's also called butterfly pose. So you're gonna have your feet together. You can either hold onto your ankles and gently push down on your inner thighs and your shins, or you can hold onto your feet as if you're opening up a book. Or if you are really flexible, you can reach forward and get your belly down as low as feels comfortable for you. I want you to open up your chest and you're pushing forward as your wings are squeezing back. You might even feel this tomorrow and maybe even in the next day. If you are really focusing on those back wings, pushing your chest forward and slowly pushing yourself down, hinging at the hips. You don't have to go far at all. And you're gently pushing down on your thighs. Feel the ground below you. Think about the color red or the color orange. Picture yourself rooting down to the ground, to Mother Earth. Some things you can tell yourself during this class or just during this pose is I am safe. I am protected. I am loved. I am perfectly imperfect. I am brilliant. I am creative. I'm a sensual being. Okay, so now we're just gonna bring one leg out, the other leg to the inner thigh. I want you to reach up and breathe in and reach down for this leg. You don't have to go far here at all. Again, you're hinging at the hips as far as you can go forward. And then from there, you can melt down. Feel free to round your back, it's okay. Get down to a comfortable position. Just melt down into that thigh. Every breath in creates space. Every breath out, move into that space. One more breath in and out. Okay, come on up. Let's move it to the other side. So other leg out, this one in. Okay, so other leg is out. Okay, toes are facing up. Reach up and breathe in. And over you go. So again, hinging at the hips. You don't have to get down far, just to a point where you feel comfortable, and then you can melt down. Sorry about the dog in the background. It's actually good practice to help you to be able to ignore background sounds. Also, sometimes it could bring our attention to where our thoughts have been. So be an observer of those thoughts. One more breath in and breath out. And sit up. Okay, so bring your legs to one end. We're just gonna do a staff pose before we go down for Shavasana. So legs are straight out, feet are up, breathe in, hinge forward, and then melt down. Now, if you have a sore lower back or really tight hamstrings, feel free to bend your knees. Bend them as much as you need to feel comfort. Yoga does not have to be painful. You should be able to find comfort in each of the poses. If you have pain, please don't do certain poses if you have pain. There's definitely a difference between pain and feeling a bit of strain and stretching. So it's about learning what is good for your body and what might not be good for your body on certain days. Now, if your body is always feeling tight and agitated, let's say, in the morning, trying to get your joints moving. If you have a lot of stiffness in your joints,
It might be that your body has a lot of inflammation it's dealing with. And so you might want to consider cleansing some things out of your diet. But again, it's up to you. You know, we all need to, we're drawn to trying things or not doing things. So I know sugar is a real culprit of inflammation, as well as caffeine and alcohol. So if you can cut some of those things down, out, or cut them down regular, what am I trying to say? If you can cut some of those things out or cut down the amounts that you consume, it can really help. Okay. Here we go. We're ready for Shavasana. So well deserved. So I'm going to bend my legs. I want you to slowly come down vertebrae by vertebrae, working some core as we're going down. Okay. Hi, Chewy. So for Shavasana, you can either choose to stretch out like a big letter X, or just your legs, Chewy, just your legs out, your arms at your sides. If you want lower back support, feel free to put blocks under your thighs, just above your knees. Or what you can do, we've been really working on opening those hips, so we can continue with that. You can go into a cobbler's pose or butterfly pose lying down. And if you want, you can put pillows or blocks underneath your thighs to have extra support as your legs melt down. So find the pose that feels best for you. If this does not feel good on your back at all, you can also bring your knees into your chest or simply go on your side in a fetal position. Okay, so find what feels good for you. You can even get a pillow and put it under your head. You can snuggle under a blanket. You can put on socks. So whatever feels best for you. So I want you to continue breathing in and out through your nose. Bring your attention to your feet. Send some breath to your feet and to your ankles. And as you release the breath, just see how they relax even more into your mat or into the ground. Let's make sure our shins and knees and thighs are fully relaxed. So send breath to them. And as you breathe out, just relax them. Send breath to your glutes, to your genital region, to your lower abdominals, your lower back. And relax them. Send breath to your belly and your mid-back and melt them down into the mat. Send breath to your chest and upper back, to your shoulders. And relax them. Send breath from your shoulders all the way down your arms to your fingertips and relax every single part of your arm, your hands. Send breath to your neck and to your jaw. Send breath to your neck and to your jaw and your chin and fully relax them. Send breath to your cheeks, your nose, your eyes and eye sockets, your forehead, your ears. Melt them in down into your face and into your mat. Send breath to your ears and the back of your head. Send breath to the crown of your head. You are safe. You are loved. You are brilliant. You are creative. You are a sensual, sexual being. You can stay here as long as you like. If you are ready, you can start bringing movement to your fingers and your toes. You can reach your legs out and your arms above your head. Please don't lick me, Jacquie. Whenever you're ready, you can slowly make your way over to one side into the fetal position. And if you're ready, you can slowly make your way up. If you feel comfortable, keep your eyes closed. So once you're in a seated position, you can bring your fingers and your thumbs together. Let's integrate all of that wonderful work into our system. Take a deep breath in. Slowly release it out. Deep breath in. Next breath out is going to be through an open mouth with a sigh. One more time, lion's breath. So you're going to stick your tongue out with that sigh. Bring your hands to your heart. You did great today. Thank you so much for joining me on the mat. From my light to yours, namaste. Have a great day. Hello.
You can bug me now. I will give you love now. Yes, yes, good boy. Good boy.
Okay. That's enough. Thank you.